Hi, it's Eric Solomon. I'm here to bring you the Monmouth Pick-5 preview for Friday, July 2nd. First card of the month for July, and I put together a $48 ticket. Didn't have a single on this ticket. There's probably a couple places where I could have made a stand, but I think I prefer the coverage on this card. We'll go ahead and start with race two. The Pick-5 starts off with a five, excuse me, a 10K maiden claimer. Sprinting. I'm four deep here. I like Streetcar Jones, and I couldn't. I mean, I considered singling this one here. This one chased a loose leader last time out, setting a slower pace for a 5.5 furlong race. This is a second time start for second time since moving to the Wayne Potts Farm, and I think this horse is just going to continue to improve at this level. Definitely the one to beat here. But the 10K maiden claiming level does get a little bit tricky sometimes. Some can be unpredictable, especially in terms of form. So I do want some coverage. Both the three, Nikki's Dream and Sip and Dip, the six, both of these horses are cutting back in distance, and both have run better races at a sprint. So they certainly could be, have a fitness edge here on the cutback, have the opportunity to run a better race there. Then I'm going to throw a price in here using the eight, Wave Jumper. This is a second time starter from the Jesus Cruz barn. Cruz has two winners with five starters at the meet, and both horses have paid big prices, $27 and $80. So I think it just, I respect anything out of this barn right now. This one missed the break, was outrun, so certainly could improve and won't really have to improve a ton to be a factor at this level. Go to race three. This is a $5,000 multi-condition claimer. Four out of the eight horses in this race are coming off their first start for a claim. I'm going to use two of them. I think Sneakiness is going to be the one to beat, claimed by Jose Delgado. This barn is absolutely on fire. 13 winners with 33 starters at the meet thus far. I think this horse has better efforts in the past. Now, second time on the track, first time Delgado, makes a ton of sense. Also going to use the four, Siesta Moon. This one was claimed by Derek Ryan. The Ryan barn's a little bit cold to start the meet, but this is a barn that always gets their wins at this at Monmouth. So I'm not concerned about that. He's 2 for 7 recently off the claim. The last two efforts that this one has, it has been pretty sharp. So I think we'll just kind of continue to ride that wave and be a factor in this race. Two deep again in the fourth race, New Jersey bred optional claiming allowance. I'm on Joy's Pride, the three. I think this race just may set up for her. I think there's a lot of speed and fade type horses in this race, and I think that's going to benefit Joy's Pride. This horse has been second in the last two. One of those races was with open non-winners of one allowance company two starts ago, so certainly in good form. The other horse I like in here, number eight, Odds on Dusty Miller. This horse is an improving New Jersey bred. It was a dominating winner, two back with New Jersey bred maiden special weight. I like the effort last time, first time facing winners. I just think this trajectory continues to improve for this one. I'm going to be against the morning line favorite, the two, Taffy Candy. This one was visually striking in her debut last year in August. Hasn't been seen since, but you go back and look, she beat just an awful field of New Jersey bred maiden special weight. It was a slow time despite having, overcoming trouble in that race. Works aren't great. I'm just not willing to take a short price on that horse, so I'm going to try and beat that one here. Race five, three deep. This is the only turf race in the sequence, and I do should mention that the weather forecast is a little bit iffy, a lot of unsettled weather in the Northeast. So I've kind of handicapped this race both ways. I'm going to go three deep either way. On the turf, I like Nice of Me, making the second time start on the turf. The first start on the grass was a disaster. Just to me, I could just draw a line through that. In pretty good form. Really liked the race from this one last time out. And then the pedigree, definitely a sprinter's pedigree. Not certain about a grass pedigree, but to me, I think worth taking a stab at here. Then I'm going to use the only other two horses in the field that have been winners on the turf, the one Sand Dune and the two Deo Forte. Sand Dune, second off the layoff, had just abysmal dirt efforts. This one is strictly a turf horse. Came back in a two-turn race at 7.5 furlongs at Parks. Ran okay, showed some speed, faded a little bit late, cuts back to one turn, so that makes a ton of sense. I don't love the rail for this one, but I certainly will use them. And then the two Deo Forte got tired, setting some pretty quick fractions at Gulfstream last time out. Was facing non-winners of two lifetime 10K claimers out there. Moves up in class on paper, but to me, you look at those fields next to each other, I think he's actually facing a softer field here. So actually getting class relief despite moving up in class. If this race goes to dirt, I think the logical horse to beat is the 10 Algebraic. Was a winner at this level on dirt last time out. Two really good starts of the meet so far. I again, probably a horse that you certainly could single. I did also include the 7 Nice of Me on the dirt also, and then the 5 Kentucky Cool. Both horses, I think the 5 furlong distance might be a shade short for them, but you know, a lot of wacky things happen in these 5 furlong off the turf races, so want a little bit of coverage there. And then that gets me to the 6 race, where I think the two principals are the 8 Mr. Mazza and the 4 392. Mr. Mazza didn't fire with better horses. Both are coming out of the same race, and Mr. Mazza did not fire in that race in the slop, but has better efforts on a drier track. Third off the layoff, dropping in class, I think can sit a real good trip, just kind of off the speed, hoping that can kind of work out a trip from that outside post where it's not too wide in the first turn. If the track does come up wet, I'll certainly upgrade 392, but I will use that one regardless of track surface. This one has a lot of good races in the slop in the mud, including the last race with better dropping in here. Certainly capable on a fast track as well. But those are the two principles in this race. Anybody else would be a little bit of a surprise to me. $48 ticket, that's the way I see the Friday Pick 5. Good luck to everybody playing.